Hello, and welcome to the Ready Education Campus Cloud Training Video Series for App Administrators. My name is Andre, and I'm the Customer Training Specialist here at Ready Education. In this video, we will look at the Ready Education assessment features and how you can use them to track attendance, gather feedback, and engage with students that have had varying levels of engagement via push notifications. Let's start by logging into Campus Cloud using your credentials on the readyeducation.com website. If you don't have permission set up for the Campus Cloud, or don't have access to the tabs discussed in this video, contact the app administrator for your campus. When you first log into the Campus Cloud, you will land on the Campus Cloud dashboard. From here, you will see a snapshot of activity for your app. You can filter to look at any particular period of time by clicking the drop-down calendar in the top left of the screen. At the very top of this page, you will see a chart containing the total amount of downloads and registrations for your app during the time period selected. Typically, you will see more downloads of your app than registrations, as only students need to register for the app, and other app experiences will also download the app. Below this, you will have a snapshot of campus app activity, containing information about how many event views, service clicks, and club views you have from app users, as well as how many announcements or notifications have gone out during this period. You will see your top events, services, and orientation programs, with a snapshot of total attendees, how much feedback was provided, and the average rating for the event or service. Social activity will display the total amount of messages sent between app users, and how many wall posts, comments, and likes you've received on your campus walls. Our system only tracks comments, likes, and messages, representing real engagement from your students. You can also see which of your tiles are receiving the most clicks under Campus Tile activity, and filter this information by app experience. Finally, you can get a quick snapshot of your assessment data, including total number of event and service check-ins and feedback received. Collecting this assessment data is as easy as pushing print. Click on the event to pull it up and click the Edit button. Toggle Assessment to generate a unique QR code for the event. If you just want to track attendance, you can select Check In Only from the Attendance Type drop-down menu. If you're interested in tracking how much time people spent at the event, select Check In and Check Out. Each event with assessment on will have a unique QR code, and you can activate or deactivate the QR code at any time from the QR code drop-down menu. Next, select the Event Manager. This person will receive emails related to checking in users, including the unique QR code for the event, as well as assessment information when the event finishes. The Event Manager will need to have their Campus Cloud permission set up. If you can't pull down the Event Manager menu, make sure you have selected the Event Host under Event Details. If you specify an Attendance Manager, they will receive email instructions about setting up check-ins for the event. When your event is over, the Attendance Manager will receive an email that lists the students who attended the event. An Attendance Manager does not need to have any Campus Cloud access. If you do not specify an Attendance Manager, the Event Manager will receive this email. You can also enable or disable feedback for your event, which will allow you to gather a 5-star rating for your event and one customizable feedback question. Students will be prompted to provide feedback at the end of the event within the app via a push notification. You can also access the QR codes and manual check-in from the list of events by clicking Web Check-in under the Assessment column of the Events list. You can follow this process for any event, or from the Events sub-tab in Clubs and Groups, Athletics, Services, and Orientation. To review this assessment information, locate the event by filtering past events and click on its name. From here, you will see the name and email of each student who checked into your event, as well as the method of check-in, whether it was on their app or if they were manually added, as well as their 5-star rating of your event, and any feedback left by the student to your feedback question. You can also download this assessment data in a CSV file by clicking Download Assessment to the top right of the list. You can also directly send a message to any student in the list, giving you the ability to respond to any feedback you received. Or you can message all attendees of your event. In addition to events held by services, you can also track assessment in a similar way for service providers. Each service can have service providers, such as tutors within a tutoring service or individual financial aid advisors. To collect attendance and feedback data first, make sure that service assessment is turned on for the service. Then, when you are creating or editing a specific service provider, you can specify the attendance type, whether the QR code is active or inactive, and whether feedback is enabled to gather a 5-star rating and the answer to your feedback question. To review any of this information, click on the service provider's name to see a list of students who utilize the services provided. For more granular assessment details, click the Assess top tab. From here, you can filter engagement information by all engagements, which is all service interactions and event engagements, all services, all events, or orientation programs for any app experiences and during any specific time period. You can also download a CSV file containing a list of all engagements listed by each student by clicking All Engagements to the right of the screen. Below these filters, your assessment data is filtered into three groups: students who have engaged or attended multiple events and/or services, students who have had one engagement during that time period, and students who have had no engagement during the time period. You can download a CSV file containing a list of these students and their engagements by clicking the corresponding download button. You can also send out a push notification message to all students in any of these categories. For example, if you see that a large percentage of your students haven't engaged with any campus events or services, you can intervene by sending a message to this subset of students to help encourage them to engage with your campus's events and services. Below this section, you can find specific information for events, services, and orientation programs. Each of these subsections will have a snapshot at the top, including the total events, services or programs, amount of total attendees, average star rating, and amount of feedback received. You can also filter your top events, services, and orientation programs by amount of total attendees, amount of feedback received, or highest rated. Under the Students subtab, you will find a list of all app users, how many engagements they've had in the past week, when their last engagement was, and a button to message a student. You can send the message from any service, club, or athletics club or group. You can search for a specific student using the search filter at the top of the screen, or filter by the app experience or specific audiences. When you click on a student's name, you can also view their engagements and even filter by events attended, services used, or orientation program engagements. Click the Download Assessment button to the right of the screen to download a CSV file containing all engagement information about the specific student. And click the Message button to directly message the student, indicating the specific service, club, or athletic club sending the message. That's it! We hope you found this video useful. If you have any comments on this tutorial, be sure to add them in the comments section below. Remember, you can always access the help desk found on the campus cloud if you have a question. And be sure to watch our other training videos.